Hi, everybody. You are listening to the Medea podcast series. Medea Medical Education Academy is a global medical education provider dedicated to designing, delivering, and evaluating medical education programs worldwide. Today, we are going to speak with Stefano Taddei, full professor of internal medicine, currently working as director of the hypertension unit at the Department of Clinical and Experimental Medicine of the University of Pisa, Italy. Professor Taddei will be chairing the upcoming Medea Live webinar on Women's Health, Cardiovascular Disease and Hypertension, which will take place on November 8, 2024. This podcast is part of the continuing medical education program entitled Blended Learning Journey on Cardiovascular Disease and Hypertension, targeting clinicians, including cardiologists, internists, and general practitioners, nurse practitioners, and other healthcare professionals who manage patients with hypertension and heart failure. Some content may be of interest to gynecologists, midwives, and nurses involved in women's healthcare.
Hello to everybody. My name is Stefano Taddei and I am professor of internal medicine at the University of Pisa. And I am also the head of the hypertension unit of the Division of Internal Medicine at the University Hospital of Pisa. My field of interest in research and clinical activity is essential hypertension, cardiovascular risk factors, and heart failure. And I have the honor and privilege to chair this webinar related to women's health, cardiovascular disease, and hypertension. This webinar will be held on November 8th, and we have the pleasure to listen to the lecture of Professor Lorenza Muyesan. And the title of her lecture is Hypertension in Pregnancy, the Long-Term Cardiovascular Consequences, and Professor Rosa Maria Bruno, and her title is Cardiovascular Disease Risk in Menopause and Beyond. Both Professor Muyesan and Professor Bruni are very well distinguished opinion leader in cardiovascular disease. Lorenza Muyesan is a professor of internal medicine at the University of Brescia and the director of the Hypertension Center at the University of Brescia. Rosa Maria Bruno works in Paris at the Université Paris-Cité and is also working at the Paris Cardiovascular Research Center and in the pharmacology hypertension unit of the European Hospital Giorgio Pompidou. So we have very distinguished colleagues and they will bring us into the relationship between women's health and cardiovascular disease. The learning objective of the webinar are: the first one is to describe how hypertensive disorder during pregnancy change the women's future cardiovascular risk. Outline guideline recommendation for long-term monitoring of blood pressure in patients who had hypertension during pregnancy. Describe how women's cardiovascular risk change after menopause. So I hope that this webinar will raise your interest and will be of great help for your clinical activity.
Why does hypertension during pregnancy increase the risk of cardiovascular events later in life?
Well, this is a strong issue since the relationship between hypertension and pregnancy is relevant. We have two different aspects that we need to underline. The first one is preeclampsia. Preeclampsia is a well-known disease. You have to consider that women with preeclampsia are classified as an hypertension emergency. And this is clear, is a very peculiar situation. But what is maybe more important, because it's a more subtle relationship, between high blood pressure and pregnancy, because 10% of women have high blood pressure values during pregnancy. And this is considered very often not important problem. Okay, we take care of that, we can lower blood pressure during pregnancy, but we know now, and there is no doubt because the scientific literature is so strong to demonstrate that women who develop hypertension during pregnancy, and most of them come back to baseline blood pressure after delivery. But however, this is a marker, this is a sign of the fact that those women will have an increase in the cardiovascular risk later in life. The mechanism by which this can happen are not clear, and we can discuss later in the webinar.
Is the risk of all cardiovascular events increased?
Literature clearly indicates that all cardiovascular events are increased when women are found to be hypertensive during pregnancies. And there is evidence for the increase in coronary artery disease, an increase in stroke, an increase in heart failure. But what is also more important, and this is the most important and most solid hardened point, that is increased even total mortality. So this mean that the fact that this increase in blood pressure during pregnancies can increase total mortality clearly explain the relative importance and impact of this event for the cardiovascular health of women.
Are there any signs or symptoms that develop postpartum that indicate future cardiovascular problems?
There are several problems that we can analyze in the postpartum that underline the possibility to have a future cardiovascular problems. The first problem is when blood pressure does not come back to normal values. Usually, in most women, blood pressure, as I told before, returns to pre-pregnancy levels and to normal levels. In some cases, blood pressure doesn't come back, so the patients need to continue to take the antihypertensive drug. But that is not only the problem to be obliged to take pharmacological treatment, but also the fact that those women will be exposed to an increased cardiovascular risk. Then it was observed that after delivery in the postpartum period, women can have a myocardial dysfunction and especially an increase in left ventricular mass index to indicate stress to indicate that during pregnancy, the heart and the cardiovascular system was exposed to a stress. Because we know that a pregnancy is a stress period for the body of the women. For instance, not only blood pressure, but also diabetes can appear during pregnancies. And in this moment, we can have an increase of inflammatory marker. We can have an increase of the sympathetic nervous system activity. And so this can lead to the modification that can be present also in the postpartum period. So, another problem that we can face, not immediately after the delivery, but in the following years, but quite close to the pregnancy period, that women can develop stable hypertension. So, there are several mechanisms that can contribute to change the pathophysiology of the cardiovascular system and they can increase the possibility to develop cardiovascular events.
What role does the menopause play in changing the risk for cardiovascular events in women?
Another, I would not like to say dramatic period, but at least very important period for women is menopause, because menopause, it's a problem for women, apart from all the psychological or attitudinal problem, but even cardiovascular system is deeply affected by menopause. Why? Because of the protective role of endogenous estrogen. When in the young age, but until menopause, women are protected by estrogen. And if you see the prognosis, we know that women in the premenopausal age have a lower cardiovascular risk and a lower incidence of cardiovascular events as compared to men. But after menopause, because of the dramatic reduction in endogenous estrogen, the cardiovascular risk of women increases so rapidly, and the risk in women became superior as compared to the risk of men. And what is unknown, but is very important, that cardiovascular events are more prevalent in women as compared to men. So the fact that the estrogen deprivation can lead women to increase in body weight, and the increase in body weight can lead to hypertension, can lead to increase in the inflammation, can lead to the increase in atherothrombotic predisposition of women. There was the tentative to give exogenous estrogen in women, but trials were not so significant at the end. There is not the indication to give estrogen in the postmenopausal time. And we can do something, but we can do in the line of traditional treatment.
What preventative measures can be encouraged to mitigate these known risks?
We must be very careful about monitoring cardiovascular risk factors, and we can balance the possibility to act through the modification of lifestyle and pharmacological treatment. What does it mean? One of the big problems of women in the menopause period is the increase in body weight. And of course, we must be very careful about not only the hypocaloric diet, but also, and this is even more important, on physical activity, because physical activity is the most important anti-aging agent. Physical activity can protect the vessel from inflammation, can reduce blood pressure values, can act on body weight, and all literature is so strong in demonstrating the beneficial effect of physical activity. What is important to know is that physical activity must be performed at medium or high intensity. Is prefer high intensity. So what does it mean? Just not suggest to our patients walking, mild activity. We must encourage our patients to do a strong activity. Okay, strong activity for the single patients, that of course can be different according to the characteristic of the patients. But the concept is that the more physical activity patients do, more is the beneficial effect. Another consideration is that instead of doing 1 hour, one day yes and one day no, is much more important to do 30 minutes every day. Because what is important is the fitness, not just to do a strong physical activity one day and then have a rest for the rest of the week. So this is the first problem. The second one is a healthy diet, and everybody knows what does it mean a healthy diet, especially in terms of calories. But we have also, don't forget the drugs, because for instance, one important parameter is LDL cholesterol levels. And we know now that if you have high LDL cholesterol levels, you have to act with drugs, because lifestyle has not a strong effect on hypercholesterolemia. And one of the few real statements that we have in cardiovascular medicine is the level of LDL cholesterol. More low is the level, higher is the protective effect for our patients. And of course, we have also to control other cardiovascular risk factors, including hypertension. And in the case of hypertension, we can start with lifestyle modification. But if this intervention is not sufficient to normalize the blood pressure values, we have to give drugs to our patients.
What take-home messages do we have at the end of this podcast?
The take-home message is quite clear. Women must take care of their health. And pregnancy can be a wonderful moment for women, but they have to know that if they have a cardiovascular problem in pregnancy, and for instance, high blood pressure or diabetes, and even if when they have the delivery, the problem disappear because blood pressure or plasma glucose come back to the normal levels, they have to know that they can run the risk of increased cardiovascular risk. So they have to take care of the cardiovascular risk factors, because to prevent this increased possibility to have cardiovascular event. And for all women, they must take care of their menopause time, and it is nothing to be afraid, but take care of the cardiovascular risk factor, and especially be ready to monitor body weight, blood pressure, and to increase the level of physical activity, and to improve the quality of food, and especially the total calories assumed during the day. This is a brief overview of the topics that will be addressed during the webinar by our distinguished colleagues, Professor Lorenza Mujasan and Professor Rosa Maria Bruno. So please register yourself for the upcoming webinar. I remember the date, 8 November, and you can register at the medeaacademy.com website. I'm waiting for you on 8 November.
For more information about our upcoming webinar, Women's Health, Cardiovascular Disease and Hypertension, which will take place on November 8th, 2024, please visit our website at medeaacademy.com.